Hey, everybody, it's Scott Steen with winnersandwiners.com coming to you with the NBA edition of Today in Sports Betting. As always, I'm joined by my partner, Scott Reichel, as we have kind of made it our habit of just taking a look at the TV games here, the games that everybody's going to be watching. Everybody's going to want to know how the plays are going to go. And Scott, we've got a couple of, shall we say, interesting TV games today.
I think that's being generous. I was going to say lopsided potentially for TV games, but yes,
that works. Yeah, a couple very similar games. It was starting off with the world champion Los Angeles Lakers as they traveled down there to the heart of the South to take on the Memphis Grizzlies. Lakers got them as a 9-point favorite with 218 as the total. Scott, tell me why I should bet on the Grizzlies here.
I know you enjoy punishment. Something like that. Not really sure. These teams just played each other. If you want to do the immediate revenge angle or the rematch angle, you can do that. It's because these teams literally played the game prior, and Los Angeles won by 14. Main issue that I have with Memphis is that without John Morant, this team just is awful offensively. You know, if you want to look at who they have as shot creators, Jaren Jackson's also out. So you have Dylan Brooks and Tyus Jones as like your main two ball handlers. Maybe a little bit of rookie infusion of Desmond Bane there, but this team doesn't have many weapons, and you compare that to the Lakers. I know that LeBron's a game-time decision, as he always is, because you never know when he's going to be resting, when he's not going to be resting, but Memphis defensively is terrible as well. The Lakers, of course, have AD and LeBron. I think that Memphis has answers to none of them, or to neither of them, and I just think that offensively, Memphis is going to be struggling. So for me, I know that that's an immediate rematch, and you might expect Memphis to play better. But if you only scored 94 points against the Lakers the first time around, I don't think it's going to get much better. I'll lean to the Lakers. I just think they're going to win this game by double digits.
Yeah, this is a Memphis team that at full strength could be fun to watch, but without John Morant and Justice Winslow, Jaren Jackson's out.
This team's winless at home, so they can't even win in FedEx Forum. They've just been awful.
I see Killian Tilly is doing what he did in college, which is be hurt a lot of the time as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't.
I can't. The only lean that you could have to Memphis is this team has an immediate revenge spot or something, because on paper, this isn't even close.
Well, I will say that the Lakers have played played one back-to-back so far this season. They covered the first one against San Antonio and then missed the second one by basically a point and a half. So. They have found themselves in this position one time this year. Covered the first one, didn't cover the second one. If you want to look at that, Memphis hasn't played a back-to-back against the same team yet.
Well, the only issue you have there is that this isn't a back-to-back.
Well, I mean, it's a back-to-back, but it's not
consecutive days.
It's not consecutive days, correct.
But all I know is that the Lakers are 3-0 on the road. They've been really sharp away from home, and two of those wins have come by exactly 14 points. And Memphis is 0-3 at home. And, this team has been awful at home. Each of their last – let me just confirm this here for a second. Yeah, all three of their home losses have come by double digits. So, at FedEx Forum, they've been practically useless. I'll lean to the Lakers.
Okay. Yeah, it's hard to get behind Memphis in this spot. Like I said, the Lakers beat them by 14 last night.
Or last time, yeah.
Well, yeah, again, the day before yesterday. Sorry. I'm with you. I'm looking for a good Memphis angle here. I'm looking for a good contrarian.
I just think that if you look at the Memphis team on paper with all the injuries and everything, this team just isn't very good.
Yeah, I'd like to see this Memphis team full strength play the Lakers. I think that'd be a fun game. But as it is, this is either going to be a pass for me or a small.
I mean, if you take Memphis's full roster, assuming that Morant hypothetically wouldn't come back, of course he is, but just for the sake of this experiment, I think you'll agree that Memphis's current roster is, what, a bottom three team in the West?
Yeah, have to be.
I guess it's just not good.
Yeah, have to be. So, yeah, again, pass for me, small play on the Lakers. Any thoughts on the total?
I'll lean under. Yeah. I actually wrote an article about this for Winners and Winers, okay. So I did break this down. But I like the under. The full game that they just played ended up totaling roughly 202.
Yep.
Yeah, you're looking at Memphis here. I know defensively they haven't been good, but lately they've actually been okay. But offensively, this team is just not very talented. So I'll lean under. It wouldn't surprise if the Lakers score 115, Grizzlies score around 100.
Yeah.
I'll lean under.
I think 100 is going to be the target number for the Grizzlies there.
Mm.
And they've had the Lakers have been trending under. They played five straight unders. Grizzlies have played four of their last five going under. So if you like trends,
think about the Lakers also with Vogel, is that even though they have LeBron and AD, they don't exactly go in transition all the time. They kind of slowed into the half court a decent amount, so that kind of slows down the pace, which is important because Memphis has been an over team earlier this year with Morant, but they also play very up tempo. So if the Lakers can control the pace, I think Memphis is going to look disastrous in the half court.
Okay. All right, good enough. Let's move on. Boy, if you thought that game was fun, let's move on to the second TV game. I was just kind of looking to see what else they could have put on TV instead. But
Spurs-Clippers would have been my bet.
Yeah, that's it. You're certainly not going to put although, personally, I'd probably rather seen Sacktown and play Golden State.
Well, that was yesterday. But yes,
I got them on the sheet for today, buddy.
I don't see them playing today.
Oh, you're right. It was the last game last night. Sorry.
It was fun though. Warriors won by like 30. Curry had 30 plus again.
Yeah. He's appears to be back. So yeah, I thought that was a second back to back. My bad. So yeah, we got the Chicago Bulls and the Portland Trail Blazers. Portland big favorite here, as you might expect. 9.5, 233 is the total. What do you got here?
I haven't gotten Portland right all year. This team has just been really annoying to deal with. I'm going to take the points with Chicago. At the end of the day, I think Portland as a team is fine. I don't think they're overly great. I know that a lot of people love this team at the end of last season when they were peaking and everything like that. But you look at them this year, they are just so inconsistent. I know Chicago was awful to start the year. They've actually kind of rallied the troops a little bit. Now currently 3-4, which doesn't sound that good. But when you start the season off with back-to-back 19-plus point losses, you start out 0-3, then end up winning three your next four. But it's really not that bad. But I know that they've also haven't played anybody. They ended up losing. They beat the Wizards twice. Wizards have been inconsistent, pretty not great. They beat Dallas with a no Doncic. So there's not really much to write home about. But it's mostly just a spot play here. There's no way I'm laying 9.5 with Portland. I can't trust this team.
Yeah, I agree. That seems a little tall to me.
I think this number should be around 6.5 or 7.
Yeah, this is a Portland team that just lost by 15 to Golden State, buddy. So that's
they also gave up 62 in the process to Curry, but yes.
Well, okay. So I'm not sure what the point of that is if you can't stop
everything. Oh, no, the point I was just trying to say is that I found it fascinating because Portland won the first game by 25, and then they played again against Golden State 2 days later, and they lost by 15. So I'm not exactly sure what happened there.
Right.
But that's just another proof to me that Portland's inconsistent because you look so good against one team one day, and then 2 days later, you give up 137.
Yeah, and they do it with style. They don't just lose.
They lose
badly. Yeah, they've lost – all three of their losses have come by a minimum of 15 points. That 15-point loss to Golden State was the closest they've been in any of their losses.
Mm-hmm.
So if they win, they tend to cover. So they're 2-1 is when they've won as far as covering the spread. So
now I also know that Chicago is a bit of a COVID issue. You have Satoransky who had COVID, so because he has a positive, some other players might be forced to not play today, which is why you have seen this line become a little bit higher than it probably should be. I already saw Portland try to cover a number like this when you had Houston missing half their players, and they needed to barely hold on to win in overtime. I know that it makes sense. Chicago's a little bit shorthanded here, but I really can't trust Portland laying 9.5. I just can't do it.
Given Chicago's record or given Portland's record of feast or famine, any value in taking the Bulls at plus 355 on the money line?
I would lean to it at least. I know they're shorthanded, and I know the Bulls aren't that good. But if you're looking for a sprinkle on something,
right,
especially with the NBA being as chaotic as it has been so far this season, I don't see why not.
Okay. Yeah, just a thought. I mean, it's just kind of the way that Portland seems to be playing this year. So yeah.
I'd also lean to the over in this game.
Yeah, 233 is a ton, but neither one of these teams played defense worth a damn.
Portland's giving up 119.3. Chicago's giving up 121.3. I'm just expecting a track meet.
Yep, I don't see any way around that. All right, very good. Any final thoughts on the NBA card tonight?
curious for future reference how Brooklyn does tonight. I know that the Nets open up at -3. They're currently +4.5. Of course, Durant ended up becoming victimized by the contact tracing. So he's not going to be able to play for a week. He's missing about 4 games. If Brooklyn gets killed tonight, they're going to be fade material for the next week. So I'm really curious how they play against Utah. Utah's been pretty inconsistent so far this season, but of course they're still talented. It's Kyrie's team and pretty much nobody else. So I'm curious how the Nets are going to look. Probably not that good, but I think that's worth keeping in mind for the next week. You might be able to find some line or some angles moving forward for the next week based on how poorly the Nets play tonight.
Okay.
You agree with that?
Keeping on the Nets. Yeah, absolutely.
I don't think Durant's worth – I know that Durant's one of the best players in the league. I don't think he's worth 8 points. I think that's absurd.
Yeah,
but I'm still curious how that's going to work out.
Okay. All right, well, we'll definitely keep an eye on that. I don't hate the over in that game either.
That's fair.
Brooklyn team that under the best of circumstances doesn't play a lot of defense. So
we play no defense at all.
We'll see how that goes. All right, there you go.
Can you believe a team with D'Antoni on the coaching staff doesn't play any defense?
I don't know, man.
I'm shocked.
Surprises me as well.
Mm-hmm.
Just shows you how much of KD's team it is. So.
Mm.
All right, my friend. So there's a couple of NBA thoughts, a couple of NBA games for you. We're always curious what you guys are playing. Let us know in the comment section what you think of our plays. If you got anything else cooked up from the NBA, we'd love to know about it. And, of course, if you're looking for deep dives into these games or any other games, don't forget to stop by and check out winnersandwiners.com. Deep dives every game, every single day, always free, winnersandwiners.com. So for myself, for Scott Reichel, for all of us over here at Winners and Winers, appreciate you guys stopping by. Wish you nothing but the best for today. Hope every one of those tickets in your pocket turns into cash money back of the window. You guys are the best. Keep up the great work. And just we'll see you tomorrow on Today in Sports Betting. Take care, everybody.